I remember back in the day when getting your smartphone wet meant instant regret and a visit to the repairman, or dealing with submerging your phone in rice to remove wetness and humidity. Now, fast forward to today, almost all flagships are IP68, dust and water resistant, and a huge chunk of smartphones have a degree of waterproofing. This facilitated a new slew of smartphone use cases, especially in the photography and videography niche. People are far more confident to take their phones to the pool, beach, and in the rain without worrying about water damage because of the IP68 rating. I'm not making this video to exhaust what IP ratings are, but you should know the level of resistance your phone has before taking it out for the water lifestyle. For a phone rated IP68, it's good for 30 minutes under 1.5 meters of fresh water. So there you have it. Keep all this info in mind and find the capability of your phone. Now, that aside, I just want to let you know some stuff you may not already know or you may not be conscious about, even though they are so obvious. Most phones would always alert the hell out of you that you have liquid in your charging port and therefore you can't charge your phone immediately. Well, you could override the warning and keep charging at your own peril. I've experienced this on the iPhone 13 Pro Max and Samsung Galaxy S22 Ultra and other brands. I wasn't even able to charge my S22 Ultra properly for almost 8 days. Yes, 8 days, and my USB cable was a hit and miss. Everything returned to normal on the 8th day, thank God. On a second note, for some time, your speaker quality is gonna be crap. Although your phone is IP68 rated, which is the highest rating on commercial mobile devices right now, but you have to worry about having a wonky speaker quality for a while until every tiny droplet dries out from the grills of your speaker, every single one of them. So, have that in mind. Smartphone companies like Xiaomi use software to quicken the cleaning process by using a facial cockless speaker facial that runs a 30 seconds of audio with hopes to clear speakers of both dust and water. I don't know how effective this is, but I do know even with that, you're gonna deal with a level of wonky speaker quality, at least for the time being before it all dries out. If you plan on shooting videos or answering calls after a water dunk or exposure, your microphone quality would be subpar for a while. I remember shooting video by the pool on the S22 Ultra after a dunk, and the audio recorded was really disappointing. I was making call and the calls was not good at all. I tried recording some audio to show the quality before and after, and it's disappointing. The iPhone performed better, but not great too. So if you're gonna use your mic immediately after a dunk or close to the time frame after a dunk, there you go. You will definitely have bad audio recording. Lastly, water resistance isn't waterproof. So the next time you go dunking your phone or having a swim, always remember, it's not waterproofed. It only has a level of resistance to water. Oh, and before I forget, salt water at the beach is not fresh water in a pool or river. IP rating tests on smartphones are all based on fresh water testing. So have that in mind. Salt water is far denser, therefore a lot more pressure. And remember, it's also corrosive, so you're putting your phone through a lot of hassle if you go using it in salt water. So have that in mind. I hope this helps you and helps you make more responsible decisions. I often love to consider IP ratings on smartphones as a secondary safety net feature rather than a primary feature. So having that in the back of my mind helps me curtail the level of exposure I give to my devices. I consider that feature as an accidental feature. So that's one mindset you should have. If you like this video or it was helpful, kindly subscribe to the channel and smash that like button. Peace.